This is my Bible.
My Bible.
My Bible.
The Word of God.
The Word of God.
God.
I have joy.
Like a river.
Like
I am more than conquer.
I'm
not moved.
I'm not moved.
What I feel.
What
I'm going through.
What I'm moved.
I'm moved. The Word of the Lord.
The Word of the Lord.
God.
God.
Never change.
Never change.
My hope.
My hope
is in Jesus.
Is in Jesus.
I agree.
I agree.
With God.
With God.
God.
The God.
Of the Lord. Walking in God's ministry. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Walking in God's ministry.
Hallelujah.
Ephesians chapter 4. Starting from verse 11. Walking in God's ministry. Thank you, Jesus. Very, very interesting. In the verses 11 through 16. Walking in God's ministry. Hallelujah. A lot of people think they are working in God's ministry, but they are not. In order for us to work in God's ministry, you have to be prepared. You have to be equipped. Jesus Christ is almost coming back. The saints are still getting equipped. If you're still getting equipped, when are you going to do your work? It's almost 2,000 years ago since Christ came. We're supposed to be equipped so we can work in the ministry. But some of the ingredients of the equipment that we need, we reject. Therefore, we are not ready to effectively work in the ministry. There is something very, very important that we need to understand. If we're going to work in the ministry of God, and God is love, you have to be loving. You cannot be a mean person working in the ministry. It doesn't go that way. The person you're representing is God. And God is love.
Amen.
And the true love is a willing sacrificial giving of myself for the benefit of another without expecting anything in return. A true love is a willing sacrificial giving of myself for the benefit of another without expecting anything in return. It's all over the Bible.
Yes.
If we don't begin to love like God tells us to love, then people will never know whether you really belong to God or not. But this! Shall men know that you are my disciples if you have both love
for one
for another?
Yeah, thank you.
But the love is missing, God is missing.
Yes.
He that does not love does not have God.
Yes.
He that hates his brother is a murderer, and no murderer has eternal life.
Yes.
That's why we don't want to hear. We just are walking up forgiveness and be bitter towards people and just kind of kick around everything and still be godly. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Walking in God's ministry, very, very simple. Walking in God's ministry. Walking in God's ministry. God said in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11 through 16.
Thank
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. So Christ himself gave the apostles, the prophets, the evangelists, the pastors and teachers to equip or for the perfection of the saints, his people, for the work of service. God said, I have a work to do, and I'm going to equip you with this fivefold ministry. Hallelujah. Thank apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers for the perfecting of the saints or to equip you and me to be ready to go with the ministry. If that is the case, you cannot just equip forever. It's like you have an army. You can't equip them to go to war. They never been to war. 2,000 years ago, Christ died. He's still being equipped, not going anywhere yet. Because we want to walk in unforgiveness a little bit longer. We want to walk in spite a little bit longer. You want to walk in anger a little bit longer. You want to lie and cheat and connive a little bit longer. You want to backbite just a little bit longer.
Hallelujah.
If they don't see, when you see a tree, anybody can argue about what kind of a tree you have. Anybody can argue about the tree. But if you see the fruit on the tree, it removes all doubt.
Yeah.
If you see an apple on the tree and it's not taped on it, it's an apple tree. Unless it's taped on it, unless you tape the apple. If it's not taped on it, it's an apple tree. And nobody can argue with you. Once you can see the fruit. So, we need to see the fruit. The gift is salvation. The fruit is working with God and being obedient to Him. That's how you manifest the fruit of love. Hallelujah.
Yes.
If I give everything I have to the poor and I don't love God, I have nothing. Love is patient, love is kind. You have to be kind to folk. Can't be mean to folk, mean Christians. They don't go together. Hallelujah.
Yeah, thank you.
Working in God's ministry requires that we die to self so people can see Christ and not us. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. He alone is worthy. So he sent some apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors, some teachers to equip his people for works of service. For work of service. So that's what comes to church Sunday after Sunday, to get equipped so you can walk in the vineyard of the Lord, in the vineyard. But if you hear the word that says forgive and you won't forgive, then you're not ready to walk. Because you refuse to be equipped. Because the kind of things you have to be equipped, you don't like. You don't like some of the things that God said we need to do.
Hallelujah.
So we can be qualified to walk in the kingdom, in the vineyard.
Thank you.
People don't care about how much you know until they know how much you care.
That's the truth.
Man, that's it.
You cannot be a mean Christian. Cannot be back. If you've been saved for a little while, you have to start talking in the back. If you do that, you're working against yourself. You never make a good Christian. Yeah. You never represent love, backbiting. You never represent love, just doing your own thing. Working in unforgiveness, almost met with everybody. Show up in the room, in 5 minutes, going to have confusion. It's time for me to go. You ought not to be. You have to bring peace. You have been given the ministry of reconciliation. You have been committed to the word of reconciliation. Hallelujah!
Amen.
Working in God's ministry. Not everybody that said they're working in God's ministry are working in God's ministry. Because the ministry of God is love. And if love is missing, then you see your own ministry. It's just like people go to church, they might have a sign that says church. But if you don't preach the gospel that is convicting, then you're a cloud with the church name. Because there will be no life-changing experience. God did not call me to make you feel good. God called me to transform your life.
Yeah.
And I'm going to be responsible before God for your life. So I cannot afford to butter anything up. I just tell you the way it is. If you don't like it, I forgive you. If you don't like it, I forgive you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The Lord is worthy. Worthy to be praised. Thank you, Jesus. So when we talk about equipping the body of Christ so can work the work in the ministry, people just take the equipment more. They don't want to work. They want to fornicate a little bit, commit adultery a little bit, lie a little bit, cheat a little bit, work in unforgiveness a little bit, backbite a little bit, just a little bit of everything, like a smuggler's board of mess. A smuggler's board of mess. To equip God's people for the work of service so that the body of Christ may be built up. Until we all reach unity in the faith and in the knowledge of the Son of God. That the body of God might be built until we all reach unity. God said, I want unity in my body. I'm going to have unity when somebody always busy lying and backbiting and conniving and going through. He will not have unity. God said, I'm going to be removing the wrinkle very soon. I'm going to remove the spot or wrinkle because I'm coming back for a bride without the spot or wrinkle and I'm about to come back. So I got to remove the wrinkle.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Say, don't be a wrinkle.
Don't be a wrinkle.
Thou shalt not be.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory.
Come to the unity of the faith. So whatever we do, whether we're together or we're not together, we want to what's what? Unity of the faith. Unity. What am I doing to make the body united? What's my part? What's my role? What can I do? Hallelujah. Can somebody know I'm a Christian without me saying I'm a Christian? A Christianity is not what you say, it's how you live. It's a way of life.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Get off that thing that says, well, I'm a Christian. Then show me then.
Yes.
Show me how you live.
Yes.
Are you loving?
Yes.
Are you snappy?
Yes.
Are you kind? Or are you mean?
Hallelujah.
And there's some fruit so you can remove all doubt.
Amen.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Become mature. Until we reach unity in faith and in the knowledge of God and become mature. You know what a mature Christian is? People that are able to discern between good and evil, He's trying to tell him, don't find the case, don't come back. You don't have to chase him down. Instead of them, it's an inward conviction.
Yes.
You have a conviction.
Hallelujah.
And you follow the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
As many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God.
Yes.
He didn't say
yes.
Boys, sons. He didn't say children, sons.
Yes.
Sons is the builder of the family name, the builder of the character of God. Hallelujah. God said, I'm going to yield to me. Put to practice that which you hear, and the peace of God will be with you. Stop letting the word of God slip by your hands and by your heart. Don't be like a basket, you pour some water and it goes every which way. He said, no. Be a container that can hold the truth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We're living in the very last of the last days.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Come to maturity, attending to the whole measure of the fullness of Christ. He said, when you come to maturity, then you won't be swayed by every wind of doctrine. Somebody will come and tell you something. If you don't know the word of God, then I don't worry about it. Why? Because I know what the Bible says.
Yeah.
But if you don't know what the Bible says, then you got a problem. You're going to be swinging. Anytime you have a wind, the leaf go in the direction of the wind.
Yes. Right.
Because I don't want to go like a wind.
Yes.
Therefore, be steadfast, unmovable, abounding in the work of the Lord. For as long as you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain.
Yes.
You're all of the time to do things as unto the Lord, and people act a fool. They treat you mean they. Don't worry about them. You're not doing it for them.
Yeah,
if you're doing it for them, you can be discouraged and quit.
Yes.
Yes.
But as long as you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain.
Amen.
So you do it as unto the Lord.
Jesus.
Don't want to act a fool, just keep on loving them. Why? Because God loves everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah. Even the family of God is like you're making a forge, you know. Even the family of God, like you're making a forge, you know what I mean? Really nice, put everything with a few knots. Few bananas,
yes.
Go bananas and go nuts, and still Christians, and God still love them.
Yes, yes.
I'm not going to go to a church where I can be loved. He's about to bring the fruit with you.
Yes.
You're going to look for a fruit when you're about to bear fruit. What's going on with you? What's going on with you? Why can't you bear fruit? Why are you looking for fruit when you're supposed to bear fruit? Fruit is a sign of maturity.
Yes,
I'm going somewhere. See? Working in God's ministry require that we be selfless.
Right,
you don't think about yourself all the time.
Amen.
The Lord will let him say, too many Christians are too self-centered.
Yes.
My cat, my dog, my house, my everything. Just pray for my everything. Why am I going to pray for somebody's something? No. You're too busy thinking about myself only. But as long as I think about myself, I will never love. Because love is a giving sacrificial of myself for the benefit of another without expecting anything in return. It's called an outreach. Outreach. Anything I don't give anything out, just take everything without getting it. It's like a Dead Sea scroll. Dead Sea. It takes everything and nothing come out.
Hallelujah.
For the perfection of the same, for the work of the ministry, the Bible says every joint supply, every joint supply. Every joint. You have something to give. I don't care if you just come to church and sit down. You have some. Your presence only. He said, forsake not the assembly of the saints. I don't want to go to church because the Bible says come together. It's called a corporate anointing, not present in individual. If you don't want to do it, no problem. Just be a renegade Christian. A disobedient Christian. A disjointed Christian. I don't have to go to church. You don't take all those. The church is in my heart. Okay? Have you ever read Hebrews before? It said, that's a forsaken the assembly of the saints. Forsaken the assembly of the saints. Because when we come together, there's a corporate anointing that is not present. And God knows what he's doing.
Yes,
he if you think, oh, I'm a prayer warrior, I just pray for everybody, nobody pray for me, you are in trouble already.
Yes.
The Bible says, whatever two or more shall come together in my name.
Yes.
Whatever two or more, in the midst of it, would that be?
Yes.
So I'm going to make two or more out of your 7 days.
I'm
going to make two or more out of one. Yeah, I pray for everybody. When I pray, okay. Even Paul, I wrote the author of the New Testament, said, pray for me that I may be able to proclaim the word of God with boldness and authority. Pray for me.
Yeah,
we pray for each other. You pray for me and I pray for you. Only a fool will take it. He pray for everybody and nobody pray for him. He meant to tell me he supplied everybody and nobody supplied you. God will allow you to go through some things that will require somebody to pray for you. And they won't go away. One will put the talent on the flag. Two. See? So God put down on demons, God put the talent to fly. So don't make it that way, so you don't depend on yourself only. with the chest all out. I'm just going to do something. How many of you are going to do something? You will humble yourself before the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Oh, glory be to God. I feel the preacher man coming up.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. So a lot of people are spending God to bless them, to do a kind of everything for them. Only one problem. You have to show up in the vineyard. He said, go in the vineyard. Go and work whatever is what I pay you. But we'll show up in the vineyard. What if you're trying to go to work? I think about your clothes and your shoe and your ear and your this and your that and your gas in the car. And you don't show up at work. You'll never get paid. And don't get paid if you don't get paid. You gotta show up. No work, no pay. You cannot sleep in the kingdom.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He alone is worthy.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. What is the work of God? The work of God is to believe in what he has sent.
Hallelujah.
We need to get off that thing and let God use us for it. And stop focusing on yourself only. Get out of the selfish mode. And say, Lord, you know something? Use me to help somebody today. Use me to be a blessing to somebody today.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Too many saints are focusing on themselves. Everything is going to pray for me, me, my cat, my house, my dog, my cat, my house, my dog. Why pray for last week? My dog or my cat this time? What did I pray for last week? My dog? Let's pray for my cat this time. My house, my cat, my dog, my job, my children, my mind. My everything. I didn't expect God to be really blessed. Because in the vineyard, if you're self-employed, you don't expect somebody else to pay you, do you? If everything is my cat, my everything, then you're self-employed. Do expect God to pay you. Thank you, Jesus. Working in God's ministry requires that we die to self. Working in God's ministry requires that we come to maturity. When somebody is backbiting and lying, say, hey, let's come together. Let's pray about this. This is what we need to do. Let's pray about this. That's what mature Christians do. You speak the truth in love. That's what mature Christians do.
Amen.
It is stronger than the infirmities of the weak. You don't make mockery of somebody just because you think you're stronger than them.
Yeah.
You are in the same body, the body of Christ.
Yes,
you belong to God. But don't to any of those. We are in the same team. We are born again. I don't care if born again 3 seconds ago. They are born again. It's by grace only, through faith only, and in Christ only are you saved. It's a gift from God. Nobody can argue on this. Don't have a chip on your shoulder. I've been saved for 20 years. Somebody missed it one day. I've only been saved for like 2-3 years. And God told me, he said, you see this guy hanging in the sling, fracturing his arm, he said, go and pray for him, he'll be healed instantly, right here. So I didn't know the guy's a pastor, I just kind of walk up to him and say, sir, God told me that many, many times. I kind of not say anything, he kept on bringing it. So I said, okay, I got it, Lord. So I walk up to him and I said, sir, God bless you. My name is Bori, nice to meet you. God want me to pray for your shoulder. God told me if I pray for your shoulder, you will be healed right here, right now. He said to me, so how long have you been saved? I said, 3 years. He said, well, no, thank you. I'm the pastor. I said, oh, okay. God really bless you, keep this thing. God really bless you, keep this thing. I'm not in pain. You got this thing, if you got this thing, I'm not in pain. I said, you have a nice day. Don't you know you have to be saved for 20 years to pray before God can use you to heal? Don't you understand that?
No.
Don't you know it's you doing it? So you got to let it simmer down for 20 years and then now you can pray for something.
Uh-huh.
Gift from God! So some get the gift of healing and I know I got the gift of healing and I know if I bought about it.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So people look at the external thing, they look at the qualification. I don't care if somebody got saved 5 minutes ago. God can use them to change your life forever.
Yeah. Yeah.
The Bible says, iron sharpen now. You don't know which iron is going to sharpen you.
Yeah.
So stop looking for wood.
Hallelujah.
Wood the iron, stop looking for wood.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. That's what we're missing.
Yeah.
Lord, if you're going to sharpen me, I want this. To be a blade, to be like this, the way I want it to be before you can sharpen me, Lord. Somebody told me one time I got saved not long, and I want to get everybody saved on my project like me. I used to work in the East St. Louis, in the hospital, the boss really liked me. Because if you're busy, he said, Bori, you going to lunch? I said, no, let's just finish all these patients before we go. So we finish everything. So it's not busy. He said, Bori, just go and relax. Take your time. I know you're a very hardworking person. So I'm telling everybody about Jesus on the job. I just told everybody about Jesus openly. I just got saved and I want everyone to be saved in 5 minutes. No reason. So the boss comes and says, Bori, you know you cannot tell everybody about Jesus just openly like that. You have to use some wisdom. I went to the morning prayer the following morning. I said, wait a minute now. I said, gotta be the devil. I'm trying to tell everybody. I know it's gotta be the devil. And one lady said, let me tell you something. With the bad attitude, say you're wrong. They're not paying you to go and be doing that on the job. You have to be tactful when you do it. You know it's wrong. You know you're wrong. I was praying for somebody to agree with me in prayer. She got me all deflated. I was upset. I didn't say anything. I turned my head. I walked away. I got to the prayer next morning. God said, you know something, that lady was right. You have to do it with wisdom. So when you see her today in the morning, in the prayer, go and tell her you love her. When you see her in the church next week. Oh, that was difficult for me to do. I thought it was the devil. But he told me to my face, he said, you're wrong. We need somebody that speaks the truth to us in love.
Yes. 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 Thank you, Jesus.
You don't want somebody that will tell you, you're about to put your hand in the fire, but they look beautifully blue. The blue flame is the hottest part of it. Oh, you need the good. Yeah, just put your finger, it's good. I want to burn your finger off. Well, it's cute. Blue is my color. That's what we want, somebody that will stroke us, not somebody that will yank us.
Right.
You need to have somebody in your life that can speak the truth in love to you. Because none of us have arrived here, we are a work in progress. I'll be the first one to tell you. You understand, you know, men at work, God at work, and you look at me on the table and say, hey, I'm working on my boy. I'm working on my boy with the accent. God at work. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, glory be to God. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for this day. She turned me off. I didn't like it. I was upset. Because I was a baby Christian, and I didn't know I was a baby Christian. I thought everybody would be saved in 5 minutes. I said, use wisdom. You can't just go up there like that, blasting. I said, no, you are wrong. They're not paying you to do that. So you have to use wisdom when you do that. She said she was rough. She looked at me right in the face. I said, you're wrong. You got to nerve. I was on the devil. The devil said, no, you're wrong. So where do you put the devil in this? Nowhere. We have zeal, but not according to knowledge. So we need somebody that will speak the truth and love to us without having a bad attitude. If you don't want to change and someone speaks the truth and love to you, you're going to get so mad. You're going to be scrubbing your chair, all upset, all uptight. When is it going to finish? When God is finished with me? I'm not in a big rush. Thank you, Jesus. They know that I'm an infant, tossed back and forth by waves, and blown there, blown here and there by every wind of teaching, and by the cunning and craftiness of people in their deceitful scheming. So there are people in the body of God that are deceptive. They say something is almost the Bible, but it's not the whole Bible. And if you're not careful, you're going to latch onto it and start swinging along with them. So watch out for people that make you swing. Because you have a half Bible. Definition of a false prophet is not somebody, it's not that everything is false. If it's one quarter false or one eighth false, it's still false. That's what people can't go to the scripture, right? He said, we claim to be the Son of God. I want to jump down from this top here. If you claim to be the Son of God, jump down from this height. For it is written, he shall give his angels charge over thee. The devil told Jesus there.
Yeah.
He said, it's also written, you should not tempt the Lord thy God. It's also written. The devil told Jesus Christ to jump from the height. He said, it is written, he shall give his angels charge over thee. You know the part of it in God? In all your ways of obedience and service. In all your ways of obedience and service.
Yes,
so don't start jumping in the hoop in disobedience, expecting God to catch you. Some people are ignorant. He said, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge.
Yes.
If you look at the Bible, Daniel was thrown to the lion's den.
Yes.
For praying. That's why he was praying. He opened the window, faced the east, and prayed 3 times a day. Interceding for the people of God, for the people of Israel. They said, well, king, did you make a decree? Did you have it sealed? That if anybody prayed to any other god other than you for the next 30 days, you're going to be thrown to the lion's den. Oh, yeah. Isn't that to say? He said, that Hebrew, that Daniel, he was praying. We caught him praying to his God. So they put him in the lion's den. And the Lord shut the lion's mouth up. Wherever you are, yet I walk in the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for thou art with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You know what somebody did in Nigeria, a prophet? He went and jumped in the lion's den. He said, because God kept
God damn it.
Daniel.
Damn.
And he was mauled. He was killed. In all your ways, Daniel did not jump in the lion's den just because he didn't have nothing to do. So you have to be extremely careful how you handle the word of God.
Yeah.
Get the whole concept of God.
Yeah.
And let God be the one that leads you and guides you by His Spirit.
Hallelujah.
And stop acting foolishly.
Amen.
In the name of the Lord.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, that was very sad that the guy was mauled. Because he said he read that God kept the lion's mouth shut in the Bible for Daniel. So when I jumped into the lion's den, and was mauled instantly. They didn't give me a chance to hit the ground. Well, pray for the family. Ephesians 2:10. Oh, I'm sorry. Where did I just stay? Okay, let me see. Make sure I clean this. Okay, so, toss back, I go back to Ephesians 4, you know, again. So, I'm going to finish that scripture, then I go from there. So don't get tossed here and there by every wind of cunning and craftiness of people and their deceitful scheming. Deceitful scheming. So there are people in the body of God that have a deceitful scheming. And the devil is the one that does scheming. Wives of the devil is schemes. So if there's any scheming going on, it's an extension of the devil.
Yeah.
If there's any scheming going on, it's not from God. It's extension of the devil's work in the schemes. Hallelujah. Instead of speaking the truth in love, we grow to be like him in every respect. The mature body of him who is the head, that is Christ. Okay, now Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10. Ephesians 2:10 it says, for we are God's handiwork, for his workmanship. Created and dragged you to do good works. God said, I made you to do good works. I made you to do good works. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I made you to do good works, which God has prepared in advance for us to do. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He alone is worthy. Worthy to be praised. 2 Corinthians 5. Hallelujah. Glory be to God in the highest. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. 17. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. It's a new creation. Old has gone, the new is here. Old has gone, the new is here. What's old? Old habit. Old unforgiveness. Sin has to do with the old serpent. Old, it's an old unforgiveness. Old habit. The way you used to do, the way you used to have before you got saved.
Yeah.
Boyfriend that you used to have before you got saved.
Yeah.
You can't, well, I know you saved, you ain't gonna hold nothing. Yes, you will. Is that you come in or they take you out? And you're not taking me out, so you have to come in.
Amen.
I remember the day I got saved, I was so happy to be saved. Before then, every weekend, if there's no party, we make sure we make a party happen. We contribute $50 a piece. They said, what are you doing? We don't know, but there's a party here. Just made it happen. Well, we got to have the big boombox and the beer boombox put in the basement. They said, what's the occasion? We're just having a party. No reason. $50 a piece. And then I gave my life to Jesus. I got saved. I closed my eyes. It was very, very bright. I opened my eyes. It was kind of dull. I closed my eyes and like, whoo, this is great. Something happened to me. I was so excited. So I went down the list of my group that paid 50 bucks a piece to have a party. And I began to tell them, ooh, you know something? Let me tell you something. I got saved, man. I'm telling you, I closed my eyes. I can see the bright light. I'm telling you, God is so good. I am saved now. It's almost like they were muted on the other side. When the father came, when the father opened the mouth, said, oh yeah, we come together next week. I went to the next person, same answer. I went to the next person. Oh, it's almost like the planets come together next week. It's been 30 years more. We haven't come together yet. They're not interested in salvation. But I went down the list. I think they knew where I stood. They won't be calling me for 50 bucks anymore. Because we change partners. Yeah. We're in the kingdom of life now. I cannot try to go back to the disco and be trying to be drinking and to be doing something in the back and smoking and sticking and sliding. No, you belong to God now. You have been washed. You have been justified. You have been sanctified. You have been redeemed. You have been set free. You have been made whole. You belong to God. You have been sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise. You belong to Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
We're a new creation.
Yeah.
We belong to God now.
Yeah.
Start acting like it. Yeah. When people do you wrong, don't take it to heart. Forgive quickly.
Yeah.
See, the thing that you want to do, if you know what the price is, then you're going to do the right thing.
Yeah.
You have God said, I got a big plan for your life. And don't let this unforgiveness or bitterness stop you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Don't get antagonistic. Don't get mad in every drop of your heart. Don't do that. God said, see, if I get mad so easily all the time, uncontrollable anger. I said, they got to pay for it. If they don't pay for it, they do it again.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. See, when you get so uncontrollable, when you have this anger, and you get mad so mad, you can destroy the work of God when you get mad. You know that?
Yes,
Moses was a man of God. He got so mad and slammed the tablet down on the ground, and he broke it. The handwriting was the handwriting of God Almighty. Handwriting of the Almighty. Would like to see the handwriting of God? Well, Moses broke it because he was mad. So be extremely careful not to destroy the work of God, because you're mad.
Yes. Wow.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, glory be to God. I send the presence of God in this place.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, new creation, the old has gone, new is here. And this is all this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ, and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. So, the Bible says, I've given you the ministry of reconciliation. What does that mean? When people are acting a fool, we're supposed to put them together in love.
Yeah.
Not divide.
Yes.
Not divide.
Yeah.
You have to have the mind of Christ. You want unity.
Yeah.
The unity of the spirit in the bond of peace.
Hallelujah.
So what are you doing to bring unity into the body? That's the question I had to ask you.
Yeah.
Are you dividing when nobody's watching and like a gathering when nobody's looking? What's your role? What's your purpose? Oh, you born again. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Give the ministry of reconciliation. Verse 18. That God was reconciling the world unto himself in Christ, not counting people's sins against them.
Yes.
He said, I'm going to use you to reconcile, but I'm going to reconcile you using the gift I gave you. Do not count what they did wrong towards you.
Yes.
That's so powerful. That's so profound. How many of us would like to not to count somebody something against somebody when they sin against us or they do us wrong? That's what he's saying. He said, if you're going to bring them to me, don't count what they did wrong. Because if you count what they did wrong, you never bring them to me.
Yes, sir.
How did you get saved? God said, I'm not counting. It wasn't counting what I did wrong. I was a complete mess, and God saved me.
Amen.
You're a complete mess, and God saved me too. So, if you're a complete mess, and God saved us, why don't you have mercy on somebody else that didn't help from us?
Yes.
By grace and letter, fellow man, in Christ, you say, a complete mess, a wretch,
yes.
Full time wretch.
Yes.
God said, by grace and letter, fellow man, in Christ,
yes.
He said, for God reconciled also himself through Christ, not counting this is a recording. If you stop counting, everybody can speak to us. Maybe you can hear from God again. Because counting many things that people do to you, and you're always mad, always bored off, always angry. And they're going to see all kind of manifestation of sickness coming out of your body. Because the holding on to that will belong to the devil, unforgiveness and bitterness.
Wow.
How did God save us? Not counting what we did wrong.
Thank you, Lord.
So if you're sitting here today and you feel like somebody did you wrong, not counting. That's how you're going to bring them in. If you count, you never reconcile. And if you don't reconcile, then you're not working in the ministry. Because you choose to work in unforgiveness, God said to love. Love covers multitude of sins. Let go of all offenses. So you can be free. So you can sleep like a baby. You're tied up in a knot. And then all met with somebody at work. And then when you get there on Monday, they're off. And all weekend long, you're toiling. All weekend long. That's what I'm going to do when I get to work. All weekend long. How you doing? And then Monday morning, that knucklehead is off. Not counting. Not counting. Not counting.
Hallelujah.
I know it's difficult because you don't want to let go of it. That's why I can't work in the ministry yet. Because you want to come when God said, don't carry counting. Peter said, how many times should I forgive? Somebody make me mad. He was taking maybe two. God said, 70 times 7. 490? 490 times? What does that mean? Lose track of it. Don't count. I got only two cheeks now. Slap this one. I got only two cheeks, right? That's what they say. I got only two cheeks. Thank you, Jesus. Not counting. Not counting. You've got to count all of us go to hell. All of us. No exception. You know what? All men have sinned and come short of the glory of God. The wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. Will you be an extension of Jesus today?
Amen.
By not counting. By letting go of all offenses. If you don't let go of offenses, then you're killing yourself. Yeah. It's like drinking poison and expecting somebody else to die.
Yeah.
When you're working on forgiveness, you manifest sickness in your body. You better let go of all offenses and be really kind. And be genuine in your work with God. Be genuine. Let it be genuine forgiveness.
Yeah.
Don't just endure folk. Forgive them for you.
Amen.
Some people endure you, they don't, can't stand you. They endure you, but they can't stand you. Okay, go on, don't worry.